outstanding ovation. Let's receive my son. I want you to declare it clearly. I am in the King's chamber.
I am in the King's chamber.
I know I am in the presence of the Lord.
I know I am in the presence of the Lord.
I am in the presence of the Lord. I want you to know one thing: in the name of Jesus, you are part of a big thing. For you to be a member in this church or part of this commission, you are part of a big thing.
Yeah.
I am not psyching you, I am telling you the truth. As I have vowed in the name of Jesus, that is the truth and the truth alone. You are part of a big thing.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
And you better begin to plan how you are going to plug in properly.
Yeah.
How you will be part of what is happening. You will just be a bent woman.
Amen.
Get involved. God is here.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said it for a second. I said, when I came here some few months ago, when you look at it, I said, God, Pastor Coker, I prayed. Man, God has helped him.
Amen.
And God is here. The name of me. It shall be mentioned, where were you born again? Where do you worship? Who is your pastor? And the people that will be answering to the mind boggling.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are proud of pastors, Afolabi and Tutu Coker. Believe me, like my wife will say, if you are calling somebody a bishop, an apostle, an archbishop, or whatever, at the end of the day, she will ask you, is he a Christian? And I say, yes, say no. Let me say clearly, these are Christians. They are choice servants of God. They are sons and daughters of the Most High. That's why heaven bless them all. And we are proud to be related with them. And let me say, without missing words, what you do for them, you do for me. What you do for them, you do for Fountain. What you do for them, you do for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
What you do with them, you are doing for the kingdom. These are sincere children of God. They are Christians. This is a big thing happening. And sincerely, I am grateful to God that we have this church located here. You know, we come all the way to preach in the man every Sunday. We preach in the man, we preach on Friday. This church will wreck the whole of this. Light has been positioned here. And the areas that have been sleeping in darkness, light has come. That's why I say, see yourself as part of a big thing that God is doing. I rejoice with you in the name of Jesus. Now let's just lift our hands and just worship God. Let's give a praise. You know, it's a good thing to give thanks. It's a very good thing to give thanks. It's a good thing to give thanks. The Lord loves the cheerful giver. We give money, we give time. It's good to give praises and thanks. That's why we call it thanksgiving. We worship you, Lord. We thank you for the King's Chamber. We thank you for Reverend Afolabi Coker, Reverend Mrs. Tutu Coker, We thank you for all the pastors and the leaders of the church. We thank you for the staff members. We thank you for the workers. We thank you for different groups, the men's group, the women's group, the youth group. I mean, we thank you for all the groups that are contributing their quota. We thank you because they're God that never let your reward pass. We know you will reward everyone appropriately. So we say, take all the glory in the name of Jesus. Thank you for your mighty presence in this house. Thank you for those who have brought them. Thank you for where you are taking them to. Father, here today in the name of Jesus,
amen.
Father, give us the grace of your utterance.
Amen.
Let your word come with precision and power. Let your people be blessed.
Amen.
Blessed seeds that cannot but grow be given to all today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we worship in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You may be seated for a while. I want to appreciate. I can see Pastor Shaye there too. And Madam, right? God bless you both. Please forgive me if I don't know your names, other people. Don't worry, heaven already knows you anyway.
Amen.
And that's what is most important. Thank you very much. I came with some of our ministers, Pastor Cole, Brother, I keep forgetting your name. Chine, dude, come on. God has forgiven me.
Amen.
Brother Jimmy, you know, I can't forget Jimmy. My son is still there, Jimmy. So my son is there, Jimmy. So good to have you guys. I others, if I can't see you in the crowd, just forgive me. I can see some. I see Brother Paul, there, Brother Basi, and Brother Kola. God bless you all. Sincerely, it gives me great pleasure to be standing here today. I look forward to it, and I thank God for it in Jesus' name. I was asking, I was telling Pastor Kola, I said, Hilda, this place is too small.
Amen.
You see, God earmarked certain number for certain ministries. This God is too small for this ministry.
Amen.
No, that is true.
Amen.
It's true. So get ready, sir. Unusual expansion.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me sing the song in Yoruba. God bless your faithfulness. You know, I was asking after me, I said, where is that lady? So I was describing. Pastor said, she did told lady that's sitting over by the side. I said, okay, I have seen her. Then he now came out to say, that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless your faithfulness.
Amen.
Forever rewarded.
Amen.
You are wonderful musicians. God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It says, but you know that. If you don't mind, can you increase my volume a little bit? I can go very soft and I can shout. I've been trying to change. It's been difficult for me. But I will change in Jesus' name. Sometimes I go so soft. I say, what is it? No, it's the spirit that sometimes leaves me like that. But I've been trying to change. I'm trying. Praise the Lord. So I believe strongly that the life we live, honest, is never just natural. I'm telling you, more so when we're born again. And that's even as though life before being born again, those who see the lives of the unbelievers, they think that their lives are just natural. It's a lie. Otherwise, it would make nonsense.
Hello?
The truth of the Bible that talks of hell and heaven. So what if they refuse to believe in the supernatural and their life is just ordinary and they refuse to accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior and then at the time they conclude their assignment and they die, then the reality of the fact that the supernatural had always been behind the scene will begin to be known on them. Because life is not just natural. God never intended it to be and it can never be so. And many don't know. When we remain unbelievers for a long time, you know what happens? Then it gets to some stage in our lives, we're looking for the supernatural. And we don't even know that's what we're looking for. Because they're looking for means to enhance their life. And that's when people join all kinds of groups. Some will be initiated into witchcraft. Some into occult, all kinds of occult groups. All kinds, all over the place. Diverse worlds. You know why? Because there's a craving on the inside for something. Thank you. The supernatural. Because we are not created to live without minding and engaging and getting involved with the supernatural. He said, no, Pastor, because you're Africans, who told you? You go abroad and get into the, travel around, get into the bus or the trams or the train and get to the train station where people are waiting for buses or you have like in the waiting room or in the airport. Watch. Just walk and see behind the books, most of them are reading. Because everybody's standing and they're reading or they're sitting for their legs crossed, you know, and they are reading. Check what they're reading. It's something spiritual. They are searching. It is not Buddhism. It is Guru Maharaji. It is not Guru Maharaji. It is Kosan Rampa. It is not Kosan Rampa. It is now a reporter. All kinds of people. See, the natural human mind or human heart is searching for this one because we are created for the supernatural. Mm-hmm. And that's why I thank God for this meeting. And that's why I'm starting in the name of Jesus for supplication this time. Because this place will not take your people anymore. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. So why are you talking this way? Because as many as are here today will begin to understand what it's all about. And you know, they are going to take it seriously. Mm-hmm. And because they are going to take it seriously, when your life begins to change, then the life of people around you will begin to change. It's just what it is. No, that's the truth, isn't it? It's when you are here to experience something that you can be arguing with it, but when you experience the first time, so Christianity, when we come to church, it's not because we are just in a place together. No. It's because there is a mandate on the lives of some people that you must be able to bear on certain lives. They must get to know God through you. The supernatural is real. So I want to preach with the message that I preached in church today. I believe this is the third service. King Simba. Yes. I'm telling you, the same grace is resting in you.
Amen.
But it's true. I tell this one provoking the supernatural. Mm-hmm. I started speaking from late last week and I realized that God hasn't given me a release, so I'm still speaking with the provoking supernatural. Because the truth is that as Christians, the day you give your life to Jesus Christ, you are enlisted. I say, let me use that. But I know there's an English word by that. English people help me study my English options afterwards. The day you become born again, you are enlisted as a provoker or provocator. Then I don't know which is more, which is correct. But I know both may be correct. One will be English, one will be American. The day you give your life to Jesus Christ, you become a troublemaker for the devil. You don't need to want to make trouble. You're a troublemaker. Because you become light in that place. You become the land among wolves. Yeah. That's just the way it is. You become a center of activities. Anywhere you go, you stir up something. Your very life and nature stirs up something. That's why the Bible says that you are the fragrance of unto life. Unto life. To those who believe. I think that's just even like, okay, they were afraid of support death. To those who don't believe. So we are not normal anymore. Under the fire. We are not normal anymore. You see, you need it. I need it. So you need to adjust something to get this with something. Of course, you watch now with something will happen to you. Why are you so sure about that? Because Jesus said the word I speak to you, they are what? Spirit. Come on, talk to me. And they are what?
Life.
So why would we be standing and talking like life will not happen to you?
Amen.
Of course, life must happen to you in the name of Jesus. And even today, you are already with life. Amen. It's not the way it is. And we believe it. And that's it. Because that's the life. So when you come to church, you don't want life. So life must happen to you.
Amen.
And that's why the Bible says, out of my belly shall flow rivers. Of living waters.
Yes.
What does living waters, what does it do? It brings life.
Mm.
Everywhere it flows, it brings life. So your business will wake up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your marriage will wake up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your finances will resurrect.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your people will wake up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Turn the way it is.
Oh.
And because we have come to know it, so we expect it to happen.
No.
We are not allowed to live any other way than to keep on expecting things good to happen. What when bad things happen, we expect them good to happen. Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So I think I just start with this text. 1 Corinthians in chapter, no sorry, 1 Corinthians chapter 5. I'll read verse 23. If you're there, say amen.
Amen.
I'll wait for you to open to it. 1 Thessalonians 5, 23. If you're there, say amen.
Amen.
Now I'll read. He said, now. Everybody say now.
Now.
I like the way Paul writes. After advancing his case, he'll get to a place, he said, now. So that means that beyond rhetorics, beyond just hearing and sitting and folding of the arms, it's time for action. He says, now, the God of peace himself. Everybody say peace.
Peace.
All right. Yeah, the answer here, the answer here. Everybody say peace.
Peace.
Paul says, now, the God of peace himself. Let's not send anyone on there. It's not saying somebody will do it. It says the God of peace itself sanctify you, set you apart, separate you. How? Completely. You know what that means? Right in the midst of the storms of life, you will get your peace.
Amen.
Like I thought you should. I said, no matter what is raging out there, your peace will be unscathed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because when the God of peace himself takes over, he will give you peace in the midst of any trouble in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So when the God of peace himself sanctify you completely. So when we talk of this peace, we talk of perfect peace. In the name of Jesus, is somebody hearing me? The fact that you have left everything to be here in this service, in the name of Jesus, peace will follow you out.
Amen.
I say in the name of Jesus, you are taking peace back to your home.
Amen.
The devil that had upset your entire family home until now is in a bad shape.
Amen.
You carry this peace into your office tomorrow.
Amen.
This peace will follow you everywhere you go in the name of Jesus. God of peace, sanctify you wholly.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And may your whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, where I'm going particularly is, I mean, like I said to myself, if you believe in the Holy Ghost to just teach a sermon or preach a sermon, teach a topic or preach a sermon through you, there's a lot to preach from here. The God of peace, the peace of God, sanctifying you. So God can sanctify you with peace.
Yes, sir.
He can use peace to separate you.
Mm.
That's what he said. And in that separation, he said it will be total. Nothing missing. The peace of God can flood your mind that you will rest like nothing is happening. Peace of God. No wonder he says, my peace I give to you, not as the world gives. No wonder he's called the Prince of Peace.
Mm-hmm.
What about peace after all? But let's leave that. Still looking at this passage. Listen. Yeah, he's coming back again. My Lord is coming back again.
Mm.
He went away and promised. He's coming back again. He's coming back again. My Lord is coming back again. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. He's coming back again. See that passage says, be preserved blameless. The coming. So there is a lot here to remind us that no matter how much of the blessings or no matter how much of the troubles, Jesus is coming back
again.
And he's coming back for you.
Amen.
He's coming back for me.
Amen.
He's coming from this passage. And it says, with the whole spirit. You say, why? You know, Paul was talking to the church. He said, if you want them, I want them, and they won't hear. He said, then turn them up to the devil. You know why? He said, for the destruction of the body. So that the soul may be saved. That's why, here it says, this preservation will start from your spirit. It will include your soul. And the entire body. So you see how God looks at you. You see how God sees you. He sees you as a spirit. First. So if you don't think much of who you are, heaven thinks differently. You are a spirit. You are a spirit. Some are afraid of ghosts and spirits. You yourself, you are a spirit.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know who you are. What do you think we have at the graveyard? The bodies from which the spirit has come. You are a spirit. Can you see that you are more than just ordinary
body?
Can't you see? You know why? Because God made you in this image.
Yes, sir.
After his life is. Yes. John chapter 4. God is spirit. And they that worship him was worshiped in spirit and in truth. So you are spirit. Let's hear it back to your spirit, soul, and body. So you are not a body that has a spirit. You are a spirit that possesses a body. There are other spirits that don't have body, we don't see them. But they see us.
Mm.
You know why we don't see them? Because they don't have body. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
So can I take it further?
Yes, sir.
So in the spirit world, what you call that world? The supernatural world. Because it's supernatural. So then you are supernatural. Are you not? Of course, God is supernatural. I feel the fire. Hello?
Hi, sir.
Are we on the same page, everybody?
Yes, sir.
So, you know, now that you're spiritual, what about that? Now that you know that you want to begin to take advantage of what you know. Long minor, short man, how do you know my height in the spirit? After I made to understand from church history, Apostle Paul wasn't taller than me if he's a stone. Mm-hmm. And the man shook heaven and shook earth. Now, does it matter who you lied to me? No. Because who came back to me, they never realized what I'm realizing now, what her life was like. You are created for the supernatural.
Amen.
Because you are created supernatural.
Amen.
Let me give you another scripture. Well, I put it from John, number 4. That says God is a spirit, right? That says they are worshiping the apostle now.
Spirit
and that you have the capacity to do some spiritual things. Okay, Matthew chapter 18, verses 18 and 19. Whatever, verily I say unto you, whosoever you shall what?
Buy.
Where?
On
earth. Not after you are dead. Now. Here. Now. Whosoever you shall buy on earth shall be what? You understand what it means? Whatever action you take here, supernaturally, is spiritually endorsed. That is, what you are doing here is recorded there. In other words, you have the capacity to affect things here and affect things there. Because from that scripture of 1st Thessalonians 5, we live in two worlds. The natural and the supernatural. And we are different from those who have passed that they don't live in two worlds anymore. How do you sing that song? You know why? That's here. The presence of God cannot join our praises here. Yeah, our praises of Him. They will recognize that our praise is going on that is beyond natural. Oh yes, that's the Apostle John. We're telling from people of Revelation. What I'm saying is that we're able to do things here, we're able to do things there. Whatever I bind here is bound there. So I can buy things there just by taking action here. Yeah. You know what? I have the capacity here and there. I'm not just natural, I am supernatural. Hello?
Hi.
And again, the God of the same verse 13, if two of you shall agree concerning touching a thing, here on earth, if two of you shall agree. Can you see many ways of provoking the spiritual? It shall be done what? Of our Father. It shall be done for him, of our Father who is in what? So I can do things here that will bring about results. I mean, I can affect things there and bring about results. Hello?
Hi.
What I'm saying in effect is you are supernatural. You have a capacity to do things and the world will marvel. Hello, are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Glory be to God in the highest. Glory be to God in the highest. Glory be to God in the highest. So now and I know that. And how did I get to this place in the first place? The Bible tells me in the book of John, in chapter 1, in verse 12, it said, if you believe him, as many as believe him, as many as receive him, he has given what they have.